Hello students, Ashutosh here. Today we are going to see the class 8 social science chapter number 1, that is when, where and how. So friends, we know that we have already seen in our previous chapter, that is the lot of the history we have seen in the previous chapter. So the when, where and how, that is a very important part of the history. When such type of thing happen, where it will happen and how it will happen, it was happen, sorry. So let me see about, now here the timeline is given. Europe, that is we are going to see the 14th century to 15th century, that is here. So in 14th century, Renaissance is reformation, that is during the 14th and to the 16th century. Between this, discovery of the sea routes was there. Vasco da Gama, have you know that? Have you heard about it before also? That is in 1498. So, it is the part during time, that is 14th century to the 15th century. And if we see about the 16th century, it was the British East India Company was formed, was established, right? So we can now, we can see the between the 17th and 18th century, there is this integration of Mughal Empire. How the Mughal Empire, that is this integration of the Mughal Empire, we will going to see in this chapter. So here, the discovery of the new sea routes, that is in 17th century, industrial revolution is there, 18th century, American War of Independence and French Revolution also. So this type of thing we are going to see in this chapter. So let's begin, friends. So you have to just take your textbook in front of you and you have to just concentrate and try to understand. So karte hain. So in the next, there is some an overview of the period. Let's we have to overview of the period. So the curiosity of people make them historians, and thus we find the recorded version of different periods in the form of history. In this chapter, we will study about the changes that took place in India from 18th century onward. So now, friends, we know that, and we have seen a lot of history in the previous classes also. So there we have also studied what is the history, how history begins, about means great leaders, just like warriors also, just like Maharana Pratap, Chandragupta Maurya, Ashoka, and Rani Lakshmibai. Means we have seen earlier, that all things we have seen earlier classes. So next we will see, during this period, the country was divided into small and big independent states. So in this 18th century onwards, so what happened? That period, the country was totally divided into small and big independent. Now we know that India has a lot of states, and every state has small and big. So we know that the administration of these states was very weak, and the life and the property of people was insecure. Administration of these states, means whatever that states are there, that was very big during that time, and the life and the property was also the insecure. Means the people were feeling insecure during that time. This political bondage kept our country backward and delay the process of modernization in India. The bondage, that is the I have also written the gulami. The bond, whatever the political bondage there in the country, so we know that variable about the political bondage affects, and they have given the lot of bad impact to our country, and now they are also giving the lot of bad impact, right? So that is the, you know that variable. So this political bondage kept our country backward, and they take our country to the backward and delay the process of the modernization in India. Whenever we are going discuss the process of the modernization for the India, so the political bondage there come in between us, and that's why we can't we delay that process of the modernization in India. So James Mill, the Scottish economist and political philosopher, in history of British India in 1857, classified the Indian history into three different periods. That is three different periods, that is divided into three different periods, that is the Hindu, Muslim and British. We know that before the Muslims, Hindu was there, Hindus peoples ruled in India, and after that Mughal empire was there, and after that British was there. According to him, before the advent of British in India, Indians were ruled by the Hindu and Muslim rulers. So I have already told you that before the British, the Indians were there. They ruled means Hindus ruled in India, and Muslim also. That's Mughal Empire was there. So moving away from the Mill's classification of Indian history, most of the historians classified the Indian history as the ancient, the medieval and modern. This division is marked in the manner of by which the society, economy, politics, art and culture change gradually over time. Modern period is associated with the following characters: industrialization, reformation, exploration, nationalism and urbanization, colonialism. So if we see about we know that we work for the to generate modern history. Modern history means the modern India, modern period, we can say. For that we want a technology, we want all things, we have to reform to ourselves. So industrialization is a very important factor about it. So industrialization is there, reformation is there, means so whatever we have to take, regenerate and reform, to means formation, we can say the formation, reformation which means sudhar karna, right? The exploration is there, means we have to research on some basic things and whatever that. Nationalism is there, and urbanization, colonialism is there. So these are the things. Now we see the major events of the world history. What was the major events for the world history? We will going to see the modern period of India. Modern period of Indian history extend over a period of about 250 years. That you have to underline. During this time, India was a colony of British Empire. In the early 18th century, India was influenced by the relation which existed between the other European powers as well. Before we take up the study of the modern India, we shall briefly focus over the changes that took place in the world that affected our history tremendously. Some of these main events were, we have to focus on the world, that is some countries are there, they don't want to, we know that we are living in the higher society and there are so many peoples in the race, in a competition, just like we are also in a competition, the country is also in a competition. So this is a matter of that thing. So what we have done the events for that, we were done the events for that we will say. Renaissance is a French word that means rebirth. Renaissance means revival, we can say. It was a culture movement. We saw the revival of classical learning, that is culture, art and architecture, between the 14th and 16th century. That is the thing between that's happened within that period of 14th and 16th century. The revival began first in Italy and then spread to the rest of the world. So underlying guys, the revival began first in Italy. First it began in the Italy and then it spread around the over the world, right? Under the influence of Renaissance, peoples began to think by themselves and boldly questioned all established principal institutions. Blind faith in religious beliefs was replaced by logic and reason. Hence, it was period of scientist approach. So for we know that the revival that is begin from the Italy and then it spread around the world. After that, the question is for the all the established and institute that we have to also be a take a part in that, and we have to also be a research for the for the a lot of things. So let me see what we have to put. If we want the modernization, then we want to research very hard for the modernization. So industrial revolution, we will see. This revolution was marked by the radical change that replaced the handmade goods and with the goods manufactured by machines. So radical, that is the suppose the changes is there, because before that when there was not industrial revolution, so before that we are whatever we are doing, we are using our hands, and that is the handmade goods was there and during that time. But now we are we have the machines, we have the looms, whatever it means, we will see going to see here. Industrial revolution began in England in the mid 18th century. The industrial, that is the revolution, began in England, that is in 18th century. Later, that is spread to European countries. New machines, just like spinning jenny, power looms, spinning mules, water frames. So this type of jenny means that is the newer. So I will tell you that meaning. The break the trade, whatever the trade is there, so that they its works about to break the trades by means individual. And power looming is there. The looms is there means they are collecting the threads for making the cotton, means cloth. Spinning there were invented. That's the new machines were invented during that time. That is in mid of 18th century. That is in England, which boosted up the cotton cloth production in England. Due to the impact of the industrial revolution, the European powers started competing with each other to capture new colonies to gain access to raw material and acquire market for their finished product. The process of industrialization, which began in England, still continues under the label of industrial development. So we know that now we are living in modern India. So there are so many factories, textiles companies are there now in India. And we are doing making a product, and we are also selling, means we are importing and exporting facility, we are transporting our products. So why this is because of the England, because they work hard on this, and they took modern for the industrialization, they took industrialization, that's why they have given the label heads of industrial development. Discovery of new sea route. You have to listen very carefully. This is a very confusing part of this chapter. So just you have to remember all the names. So let's start. Discovery of new sea routes. The period of Renaissance and industrial revolution led to the age of the discoveries of new sea routes. Many unknown lands were discovered by European explorers like Bartholomew Dias, who sailed up to the southern cape. So underline that Bartholomew Dias, who sailed at the northern cape of Africa, that is name he given, that is Cape of Good Hope, that is given here. Thus, Christopher Columbus began his expeditions in 1492. The Christopher Columbus, that is his began expedition, that is in 1492. He sailed westward a few weeks later and reached West Indies. He wait a few weeks, and after the few weeks he reached to the West Indies. It was after the death of Columbus, that was a thing, after the death of Columbus, that the Europeans came to know of his discovery of a new land, which was named America. The Europeans came there to know what is the new discovery of that person, that is the name America. After the name Amerigo Vespucci, that is the Vasco da Gama, followed almost the same route and reached the western coast of India, that is in 1498 century. Ferdinand Magellan discovered the Strait of Magellan. Underline this also. Ferdinand Magellan discovered the Strait of Magellan and also named South America. That is, we know that the name that is the South America. The Cairo del Fuego, the Pacific Ocean, and the Pice Island, that is the East Indies, in the present day Maluka Island, that is in Indonesia. He is credited to be the first European to circumnavigate the earth. Circumnavigate, whatever the oceans are there, seas, parts are there, seas, oceans, whatever that means, they are moving all the oceans, means aaspas tairna jise bolte hain, usko bolte circumnavigate. Means he wanders whole earth ocean. So between 1519 to 1922. Though he himself could not complete the voyage, means he could not complete it, that means whatever he began, the journey of that circumnavigate, that is in the that is the earth. So he could not complete that his, and he was killed in Philippsville. Whatever the war was began there, and he was killed in Philippsville. Francis Drake, the first Englishman, who circumnavigated the world. Underline guys, who Francis Drake, he was the first Englishman who circumnavigated the world. And James Cook, the 18th century navigator and explorer, successfully mapped the Pacific Ocean, New Zealand and Australia. That is the second person, James Cook. In 19th century, he navigator, explorer, that is successfully, he mapped the Pacific Oceans also, and New Zealand also, and Australia also. So he is navigator. That's why we can also say that he is the navigator. With these discoveries, European got a chance to expand their trade. That's why the European get the chance to expand their trade's relation with the rest of the world. The English East India Company established its outpost in many countries. Now we'll see, before that, now the facilities are here. We have the aeroplanes facilities, helicopter facilities. But before that time, all the export and import system was from the only the ship, right? Big ships was there. Imperialism and colonialism. Let me see. The discovery of the new sea route, combined by the Industrial Revolution, helped these European countries to search for new markets for their finished product in other countries of the world. Let me again read. The discovery of the new sea routes. New sea route, they discovered the new sea routes. I have already told you the reason why. Combined by the Industrial Revolution, helped these European countries to search for new markets. They are always searching the new markets for their finished products in other countries. Means how to supply their products to the other countries. Means over the world, they have to supply their products. The race for the colonizing new countries increased between them. So whatever the race began between them, between the European countries and other countries also, so which gave the birth imperialism and colonialism, which gave the imperialism, the birth of imperialism. And it means war, the jisko bolte war, we can say the Cold War, we can say, and colonialism. So during this age, colonialism emerged in the world. It is represented on the map shown on the next page. It was during this time that India also became a colony of the British. So during that time, India also became the colony of British. You will read about in the next, that you will read about in the next chapter, the policy of the forcefully extending a nation dominated by territorial occupation and establishment of economic and political influence over another nation that is known as imperialism. Now we have to know our what is the perfect meaning of the imperialism. That is the political system in which rich and powerful countries was there, and the rich and powerful countries always try to control the poor countries. Means whatever the poor countries were there, so they are trying to control on there, or means with their power, with their richness, they are controlling to the other countries, which countries was poor, right? So this is the meaning of imperialism. The exploitations and control over the resources of a nation or country by a powerful country to strengthen its resources through its political, economic and social policies is known as colonialism. Whatever the exploitation, whatever the control resources of a nation by a powerful country, that I already told you, by the political system was there, and social policies is there, that is a colonialism. Better remote the sentence. Now here are some factors are here that were the responsible for the colonialism and imperialism. The dominant country required a cheap raw material to supplement their interests. Some the countries want to cheap raw materials. Have you know about the meaning of cheap? Require a cheap raw material to supplement their interests. They want some cheap material to supply for their countries to other country. They wanted new markets for their finished product. And again, they wanted some new market to supply their new products. They had developed superior war weapons, military powers, and control overseas. They want to create more weapons, more powers, military powers to control this over the sea. Why over the? Because we know that all the export and import system was the going from the over the seas, means sea ke hi samundra jo hote the pehle uske hi throughout jo business chalta tha, trading business hota tha, theek hai. They had prejudice over their culture superiority. They thought that it was a duty to civilize their colonies, so they are thinking that they have to protect to their colonies, and that's why they think that they have their duty, unki duty aisa unko lagta ki this is my duty to take the protection for them. So the last point, besides the weakness of North America, Asia, Africa was another factor that incited European to conquer and establish their political control. So besides the weakness of North America, Asia, Africa, one of the there another factor that incited, means uksana, European country ko uksate the ki North America pe kabza kare ya kuch political control jamaye. So this is the part we have seen, we have studied. I hope you might have understood all these things. And this is not a very hard topic. Just you have to know the names, means especially the part that is the discovery of new sea routes. And I have already told you that whatever the import and export system was there, just by the sea routes, they are doing the trade. Okay, so thank you so much. You have to try to understand and write down the question and answer about, and the next part we will see in the next video. Thank you.